Two big developments in the Jerry Sandusky case today. Sandusky's lawyers have revealed that they tried to quit at the start of jury selection, saying they were not given enough time to prepare their case, but the judge denied their request. The lawyers say went to trial too fast, which could be the basis of their appeal. Also, Penn State University has issued a statement saying their lawyers will reach out to the attorneys for the victims to try to settle any civil lawsuits as quickly as possible. Victim number five testified that Jerry Sandusky sexually abused him in the Penn State campus shower. Joining me, Tom Klein, the attorney for victim number five. Mr. Klein, welcome to you this Sunday afternoon.
Nice to be here.
First of all, Mr. Klein, I would imagine it's been a whirlwind of emotions for your client since Friday night's guilty verdict. How's he doing?
It has been a whirlwind of emotion. He is now relieved that this is over, but this doesn't bring life back to normal. This trial, the grand jury investigation, the investigation that brought him into this a swirl of deceit by Mr. Sandusky out in the public has caused turmoil in his life. He has a loving family, a loving girlfriend, and they're helping him get through this.
Has Penn State reached out to you and your client yet?
I've had discussions with Penn State lawyers well before this trial. They have told me that they had planned to have this kind of reach out. It didn't come unexpected to me, and I would expect them to reach out further. My view, however, is that we need to see the report of the former FBI director, Louis Free, which has been promised. We're going to want to evaluate it, see exactly what it says, and see how far-reaching the conduct was.
You have you've called Penn State's Jerry Sandusky. You've called Mr. Sandusky an enabler. You plan to file a claim against the university. There are reports that Penn State again started to reach out to victims to settle this thing quickly. When we talk about enabler, and when you talk about the claim that you are about to file, is that claim going to center solely on Penn State's failure to act in response to serious child sex abuse allegations, or will there be more?
Well, we'll see where the road takes us. Here, we know that Penn State was the enabler. I have said for many months now that Penn State was the enabler. Mr. Sandusky was the perpetrator. This trial was on the perpetrator. Now we focus on the enabler. This was a case we learned in this trial, in this criminal trial. Literally, by the time my young man, when he was a young boy, was assaulted, everyone from the janitor to the president of the university knew. And that is going to take a thorough investigation. We know that this runs deep and corrosive. Penn State has already admitted as much. But we need to determine all of the facts. These civil lawsuits are not solely about compensation. They are about accountability. And we need to have accountability here. And we need to have an accounting, a public accounting. This is important and goes far beyond Penn State. It goes into the boardroom of every board of trustees at every university from Lock Haven, Pennsylvania, down the road to Harvard.
How much are you going to be asking for in the civil suit?
We're not asking for any particular amount. You can't plead for a specific amount under our Pennsylvania rules. I am interested, first and foremost, as is my client, in accountability and full justification here. There's no bringing back the scars that are deep in the soul of the young man who I represent. You saw it in his eyes, his tearful eyes, when he testified before this jury. We're looking here to the civil litigation as a mechanism to find out the full, complete truth. We essentially are private prosecutors in this case.
Mr. Klein, one of the things that struck me, and I think one of the things that struck a lot of folks listening to the trial and afterwards as well, after the verdict was read, the thinking that there are a lot more victims out there. At this point, any indication how many more victims we're talking about?
Well, here's what we know publicly. There were documents filed during the discovery lead-up to this trial where Mr. Sandusky's lawyers were conducting discovery and got significantly more, by the way, than in any criminal trial known, at least to me, in Pennsylvania. And they filed an interesting document asking the Attorney General of Pennsylvania for the information that they, the Attorney General, had on victims 11 to 20. So we know in a public filing that there are that many. And of course, we know about Matt Sandusky. I believe that the Attorney General's office has done just a marvelous job in sorting through all of the information they had. They were 10 for 10 in 10 cases which were prosecuted against Mr. Sandusky. You have to keep in mind that the Attorney General's office didn't win one big guilty verdict against Mr. Sandusky. There were 10 separate claims with 48 counts. By the counts, they went 45 for 48, and by the claims, they went 10 for 10. That's a 94% batting average, and I'm sure, while I have no firsthand knowledge, I've seen them firsthand. Yeah. I was at every lick of the trial, and I'm quite sure that that's how they're sifting through this very carefully.
Tom Klein, attorney for victim number 5. Mr. Klein, thank you so much for your time.
My pleasure to be here.